Good afternoon, dear children. How are you all? I hope you all are excellent and very safe at home. Today we start our new lesson from the book Moments. Yes. And the lesson number 6, that is Weathering the Storm in Erasmus. Weathering the Storm in Erasmus, written by Harsh Mandel. Erasmus, the name of a place in Orissa, in eastern part of India. So, who is written? Written by Harsh Mandel. Good. And it is a fact. It is not a story. It is a fact. In the given day, it is happened. And they have given for a 9th standard. What is the storm? Storm means, you know, bhavandar. Here they have given the super cyclone. The story is written on a super cyclone. What is the theme of this story? The theme of the story is Weathering the Storm in Erasmus is a description of a brave acts. We need brave acts. Nowadays we are seeing in this corona pandemic, you know, we see many courageous people are there. They are doing their work. Really salute them. Hats off. The same thing is here in those years, in those days. So Weathering the Storm in Erasmus is a description of the brave acts of a courageous boy. To do any extra activity, we need courage. Understand? So here the courageous boy named Prashant. And this lesson, this story is about that Prashant, how he has helped the area and in that village. That is the story that we are going to be seeing only. Okay, this lesson tells us the importance of the young segment of the society. The young segment, the young boys and the young children. Boys, you know, and not only boys, the people also, okay, society, they can get together and work for the community. And the value of the young is recognized at the time of need. This is a theme. Main thing is that the value of the young is recognized. Okay, here you can say young, you can say any or any age. Understand, any age of the people, any people. Okay. Here, young. So, this is a story. Okay, we'll see about our writer, that is Harsh Mandel. Harsh Mandel was born in Shillong in the year 1955. He is a writer and a social worker. He has worked as an RAS in the state of Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh, RAS officer, the class 1, super class 1 officer in Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh for almost 2 decades, for almost 20 years. Mainly as the head of the district governments of tribal districts. He is associated with the social causes of movements such as communal harmony, Dalit, tribal, and disability rights, the rights to information, homeless people, custodial justice, and bonded labor. He writes regularly on issues of social justice. His books include Unheard Voices, Story of Forgotten Lives, Fear of Forgiveness, The Aftermath of Massacre, and The Ripped Chest, Public Policy and Poor in India. He was awarded the Rajiv Gandhi National Sadbhavna Award for Peace Work and the M.A. Thomas National Human Rights Award. He's a Indian writer. Yes, Indian writer from Shillong, born in 1955. Harsh Monday. So, we'll see a short summary of this lesson. What is the short summary of this lesson? The short summary, the chapter sketch. What is this? What is the chapter sketch? Is there just now? I will read and then I'll explain that. Weathering the Storm in Erasmus is a story about a name by name Prashant and his encounter with the super cyclone. Prashant goes to meet his friend who lives 18 kilometers away from his home. A terrible storm, terrible storm attacked. Cyclone floods the area and Prashant and his friend's family have to stay at a rooftop for 2 days. He manages to reach his village with great difficulty and is happy to see his family safe. He becomes a leader of the village and forms a team of volunteers, which helps in getting food for the victims and cleaning of the overcrowded. How many characters are here? Here only 2 characters are there. One is Prashant and the other is Prashant's friend. One is Prashant and the other is characters are, one is Prashant, And the second is Prashant's friend. Prashant's friends. 2 characters are here. Okay, so here they have given once. He decided, and this is a story happened in Orissa, that is on 27th October 1999. You know, dear children, few days back in our area, especially in our Konkan area, Nisarga cyclone. The government has only given the name of that cyclone is a Nisarga cyclone. It was, I think so, hardly few hours and distracted many villages, uprooted trees, many villages. Still, so far they did not get electricity. Much spoil, everywhere water and roofs were flew away in the air and uprooted trees and many people, they are unsheltered. They don't have shelters. Government has provided the same thing in 27th of October 1999 happened in Orissa, that is in which place? The Erasmus. And Harsh Mandir, he has written this story because he has worked in the tribal area, in many those areas, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. He worked in poor people, communal rights, and he fought with the communal rights and all. He has written that time he was an IAS officer in those areas. So, this is happened on 27th October 1999 and coming from Prashant visited one of his friend's house. After, 7 years, his friend's mother died. After 7 years, he visited that village and the death anniversary and all. And that time, and it was hardly 18 kilometers away from his place. So he went to Erasmus, 18 kilometers away from his place. And when he reached that house in Erasmus, in evening on 27th of October 1999, there came a super cyclone. The black storm gathered there, heavy and continuous rain filled the darkness. Trees were uprooted. Everything was destroyed. It was achanak. It was suddenly happened when he reached there. And within few hours, everywhere in that area, in that villages, gathered water. And this Prashant and Prashant's friends and family member everywhere in the house, completely up to, you know, here up to head, the water was there. So they were there on the roof of the their house. 2 days they were there. This much strong cyclone was. Cyclone? What is mean by cyclone? Cyclone, you know, like Nisarga, what I just now said that, means with heavily rainfall and heavy with wind. Very means 150, 200 kilometer per hour. That much speed, the wind speed. So that is a cyclone. Okay, now, so this friend, he, Prashant and his friends and his, their family, they were 2 days, they were on the roof to escape from that flood. And 2 days, what they had eaten, they were eating the tender coconut, you know, the tender coconut, they were on the roof, that they were there on their roof and they were eating the tender coconut. And when after 2 days, then he was worrying about his family. How is my family? What happened there? I am here, I don't know. And this Prashant is just 19 year old boy. Just 19 year old boy. And he was worrying about his family. And after 2 days, he come down and he started going towards his village. And when he was going, everywhere waterlogged, you know, waterlogged. And he passed from there, he was coming from the deep water. And when he was going towards his house, his village, he saw many dead animals floating on the water, dead bodies floating on the water, uprooted trees floating on the water. With the help of big log, he covered that distance. You know, he was keeping all the dead bodies and the uprooted trees and all side. And anyhow, he reached his place. When he reached his place, he went to his maternal house, you know, mama ke gaon mein, nana nani ke gaon ki taraf gaya. When he saw that, he knew all are very safe in my, even though the water logged, but destruction, no human destruction was there. When he saw his grandma, when he saw his near and dear ones, everybody, you know, he felt very good. He felt very happy to see them alive. Nothing happened with them. And all his relatives and near dear ones, when they also saw Prashant, they also felt very good and they hugged him. You know, when we see our near and dear ones with love, with care, we hug them. So they hugged him also, and he also felt very good when he saw his house. And while coming from that, from Irasma to his house, he met with two cousins there. So with his cousins, he came towards his place, that is his house. On the way, he found two friends of his uncle. They were also returning home. And on the way through, they pushed away the dead bodies of children, men, women, skeleton of animals. You know, within these 2 days, everywhere, you know, destruction. The house destruction, human beings destruction, and the animal destruction, spoil, everything spoiled. And finally, they reached the Prashant's village. Heart froze up to see water everywhere. At the first, he met his maternal grandmother at the Red Cross shed. She had become a weak with hunger. Now, those people in his village, they were there, you know, a rescue place. The government had kept them in a rescue place that we call the camp or shelter. And from 2 days, they did not get any food to eat because of water, flood area. And then he thought that the Then we see the shelter, you know, the many people had given the shelter because they left their house, because the houses were under water. So they got the shelter, and there was a final fatal scene at the shelter. Around 2,500 people had taken shelter there. The people there had survived on green coconut only. Whatever they were getting from that, they got that. Prashant took up the lead. He organized a group of youth and leaders. Then he could not see that. He thought, let me do something. So with his friend circle, he organized one group, youth, you know, few volunteers, few children like his age. He has gathered them, and he was the leader, and according to him, whatever he used to say, they were following. Then he was the leader. Then he said, he announced that Prashant became a leader of the village. He sent a delegation to the merchant and got the full quota of rice for the people taking shelter in the shed. He organized a team of volunteers to clean the shelters. See, living in a shelter, 2,500 people were there. No food to eat, no cleanliness, no place to sit properly. So he organized the food. He met with the people, those who give the food, and he arranged food for the people, those who had taken shelter in that place. And then he gathered, you know, few people, volunteers, those who are doing their own. Then he said few people, children, to clean that place and let them sit properly. So cleaning his area is very important. Eating food is also important. And he managed all the kids. On the fifth day of the camp, one military helicopter dropped food packets but did not see. On the fifth day, can you imagine, dear children, on the fifth day, means still fifth day, they were on tender coconut only. Fifth day, the government has supplied them the food packets to eat. And after that, only one day they had come and they did not return. So what he did, he gathered few children, and means that time, then he told that you lie down on the ground or on the sand or ground and keep that plate on your stomach, empty stomach, empty plate on empty stomach. They lied down, and it was a token for the helicopter, for the people, those who are flying in the air, the government, that here we are not getting food, please supply food. So he accordingly he did. Then the youth task force was set up. Then the group deputed the children lie on the floor, and they had the empty utensil on their stomachs. By that, they were able to communicate the people, those who were there in the air, communicate the people passing helicopter that they were hungry. After that, they did not come. So they were hungry. That was a token, that was a sign to the helicopter people, that we are hungry, we need food. Finally, the helicopters dropped good quantity of food there. In this way, you know, see the condition. Here we are reading only, but the original condition, if we see that, we can't imagine. And the courage that the Prashant has shown in this village, 19-year-old boy, taken the gathered few children, gathered few people, and he did that. Then he was a social worker, Prashant. After that, he was a social worker. Prashant brought orphan children also, orphan children, and made a shelter for them. He asked some of the women to look after them. With the assistance of NGO, he started food for work program. He also engaged few of the volunteers to help widows to start their lives again. he restarted that their life from the beginning. For often he built shelter, he gave a shelter for poor and widow women. For them he has given the work and gave the work also there. And even after the months of the devastating cyclone, people see the Prashant's help. After the months of the this super cyclone, they were taking help from Prashant. This is a small story written by Harsh Mandel. And we could see here the courageous boy named Prashant. So here is the short story of this lesson, that is weathering the storm in Irasma. In next lecture, we will see detailed explanation of this lesson. I hope, dear children, you understood this short summary of this lesson. By tomorrow's lecture, once you read this lesson, you will completely come to know the idea and the full story of this lesson. Thank you and have a nice day.